Alright, I'm going to spoil a lot in this, but I want to know, what can preppers learn from the film Contagion? You know, it's interesting how you can watch a movie, be entertained, think nothing about it, go on with your life, experience some things in your life, and years later you go back to the same movie, and it's like you're looking at something completely different. I want to talk about the film Contagion, starring Matt Damon. Matt Damon, Lawrence Fishburne. Essentially, this movie is about a pandemic. And this happened, of course, before COVID. And I watched the movie the first time, and it was scary to me. It was scary to me watching the whole situation unravel, because in this movie, it's about a virus that gets out and it's spread from Hong Kong to all over the world. There's in the World Health Organization, they follow professionals working for the CDC, the World Health Organization, and they try to get this whole pandemic situation under control. It has a kill rate of around 20 to 25%. At one point, it's around 30%. Basically, 30% of the people who got this contagion lost their lives. And, you know, when I first saw the movie, it was just a scary, entertaining movie. And my thought was, man, if this happened for real, it would be absolutely crazy. But then COVID happened, and the whole situation with the vaccine happened in the real world, and I watched this movie again tonight, this night. I was watching the movie today, and I just saw it completely different. It was a completely different experience. It wasn't, oh man, that'll be scary if this happened and that. It was, man, I could see the parallels between that and what is happening in our world right now. And not necessarily the pandemic, but the message, the programming behind it all. Like, for example, in the movie, they set it up so that there was this conspiracy theory guy, this blogger, who was saying that this certain drug was going to be the cure, and he was sort of exploiting that to try to make money off of it. And they were sort of portraying this guy as this sleazy character who was manipulating the masses for his own personal gain. And he was also a character who was criticizing the CDC, the authority figures. So I thought, I saw the movie and I was thinking, you know, this is really good propaganda if you want to sort of discredit anybody who's questioning vaccines, anybody who wants to question the authority figures, the CDC, or anything like that. And I just view it now as programming. I sort of look at a lot of these Hollywood movies, and it's so clear to me that this is programming. They put this out there to sort of put certain thoughts into people's minds. Like, they want people to associate people who ask questions or criticize the narrative with a character like they had in this film. And I just thought it was really fascinating. I also want to talk about how preppers can learn from the whole, some of the scenarios in the movie, but I just want to throw that out there. And how interesting it was. In the movie, you have these people dying, but then this one lady, she tests this vaccine on herself, and it works, and you know, that's pretty much the resolution of the whole story. I know I sort of ruined it for you if you didn't see it, but everybody just lives happily ever after, and everybody's life returns to normal. And now just view the film as, this is programming, even before something actually happened. And it's interesting how a lot of movies in Hollywood are out there, put out there to sort of make certain government entities look good, make certain narratives seem more acceptable. It was really fascinating. I sort of wonder what type of agenda was really behind the movie to begin with. But anyway, it was really interesting. It's an interesting movie. The Matt Damon character, his wife went to Hong Kong. She was on a business trip. She had an affair with this guy, and she contracted this virus. Well, she brought it home to her son. Their son died. She died, and his world is basically rocked. He's basically trying to survive. He is fortunate enough to be immune to the virus, but he has to worry about his teenage daughter, who has a crush on his kid. But anyway, he has to navigate that type of situation, and it's really fascinating because in the movie, some of the decisions the guy made was very questionable. For example, all hell is breaking loose about 20 days into the whole pandemic situation, and there's looting, there's complete chaos, and he decides to go to the store with his daughter, his teenage daughter looking for cereal. I'm thinking, like, don't you even know what's really going on? It's sort of a lesson. I don't know if this is a lesson for preppers, but a lesson for people in general. You know, if there's absolute chaos, you don't want to be at the source, especially in that type of scenario where people are worried about a virus. I mean, the lesson there is pretty obvious. Don't wait till all hell breaks loose to actually go to the store and get what you need. Get it before things go south. And that's a lesson you could take away from that film right there. There's another situation where a journalist, this woman, she's in the store. Again, in this scenario, there's a pandemic. This woman is in the store with a bunch of people trying to get this medicine that they all believe is going to save them. And I think they run out and people attack the pharmacy trying to get this medicine. And again, you have to assess your situation and don't put yourself in situations when you're surrounded by desperate people. That's a lesson. Do not put yourself in a situation where you're surrounded by desperate people. Another situation I'm thinking about is not really related to the movie. Well, kind of. Even if you're in a neighborhood that you think is really good, really safe, you have to be mindful of what's going on around that immediate area, the adjacent neighborhoods, because if you have some adjacent neighborhoods that are questionable, that could become a real problem for you. I remember when I was in Flint, Michigan, I met this firefighter professional who I sat down with him and we had lunch or something, and we were talking about prepping, and he was expressing his concern about living. He said his neighborhood was good, but he said that it was very, very close to a neighborhood that wasn't very good, and that was a big concern for him. And that's something that people have to be aware of. Just because your neighborhood's good now doesn't mean it's going to remain that way if things break down, because a lot of times you have two different districts, two different jurisdictions, and your area may be good because you have good law enforcement there, plenty of money for law enforcement to do their jobs there. The next area, which may be very close, could be within a quarter of a mile. They may not have such a good situation. They may not have good enforcement of the law, even under normal circumstances. So if there's a breakdown in law and order, that the chaos in the other district can definitely start to affect you. Also in the movie, they were talking about how 25% of the law enforcement didn't show up. That was really interesting. They were basically absent. And you know, in a situation where people are worried about their own family, you got to understand that people, they still want to take care of their own family. They still have to worry about their own family. I thought it was impressive that 75% showed up when all hell was breaking loose in that scenario. So even though the movie brings up a bunch of, I question a lot of things about the movie, about its purpose, there were some scenarios that were really pretty useful. Going back to Matt Damon's character, he witnessed two guys break into his neighbor's house and heard some gunshots. And he ended up going into another neighbor's house to actually acquire a firearm so he can protect his family. I thought that was really interesting how he wasn't really prepared in advance. He had to get a firearm from a neighbor to really protect his own household. Those two guys, those burglars who went into his neighbor's house and had an altercation with his neighbor, they could have went right to his house. Speaking of altercations, this guy is working for the CDC, one of the top guys, played by Lawrence Fishburne. He gets some information that they're going to shut down Chicago. And he basically tells his wife, hey, get out of town, because he wants her to get out of that area. They're going to quarantine the area. He gives her specific instructions not to go anywhere, to avoid people, do not call anyone, don't contact anybody. And she does the exact opposite. She goes to a grocery store, okay? A grocery store in the middle of a pandemic scenario, right? With absolute chaos. She goes to a grocery store, then she jumps on the phone and speaks to a friend, and of course this all blows up in Lawrence Fishburne's character's face later on in the movie when it's exposed that he warned somebody about the whole situation. But he sort of redeems himself by trying to help out a little kid, giving some kid his vaccine, which is kind of cool. I thought that was a nice little story arc right there. But these are some really interesting things that the movie sort of highlighted. And it's something that, you know, it gets you thinking about, okay, what would I do in that type of situation? How would I handle this? And how, most importantly, how would I avoid something like this? This is something, you can really learn. This is something you can really take from the film. So if you get a little time, it's worth watching. I know I spoiled a lot of it, but it's just something I just wanted to really talk about as far as emergency prepping and everything. The scenarios were really fascinating. So there you guys go. I have a question for you guys. Have you seen a movie recently and just viewed it completely differently because of your own life experiences? What type of movies do you view differently because of your own life experiences? Maybe, I don't know, you became a father and you sort of view the movie fatherhood or parenthood differently. Share those experiences with me, guys. Again, I'm going to continue to talk about the situation with the vaccine, COVID vaccine, and the virus, obviously. I'm going to talk about current events. I'm going to have some more gun reviews, but I'm also going to mix things up and do a little movie reviews as well. All right, thank you for watching. Thank you for listening. And don't forget that the future belongs to those who prepare for today.